Factory at Sea, How China Raises Billions of Fish Daily, Amazing Aquaculture, Fish Farming Trends.
There's something you need to see. Our traps in the East Lagoon, they're pulling up less and less fish.
Then we'll rotate the fishing grounds.
There's no fish.
Oh. Then we'll fish the far side of the island.
We tried.
The windward side?
And the leeward side, the shallows, the channel. We've tried the whole lagoon. They're just gone.
The depletion of wild fish stocks is happening at an alarming rate. According to the World Wildlife Fund, 53% of fishing grounds are fully exploited, and the global fishing fleet is 2 to 3 times larger than sustainable levels. At this rate, commercial wild fish populations could vanish by the middle of this century. In China, fish farming has reached an incredible scale and significance. It accounts for an impressive 60% share of the world's aquaculture production. People now eat more farmed fish than wild fish. Taking fish farming offshore. Genghai number 1. An offshore platform built by China Shipbuilding Industry Corporation for Shandong Marine Group was completed in October 2021 for aquaculture operations in China. This marine ranch complex, the first of its kind in China, includes facilities for fish farming, fisheries enforcement, scientific research, and recreation. The platform features advanced AI and 5G-based systems for environmental monitoring, automated fish feeding, and collision prevention at sea. Additionally, underwater robots manage patrol and enforcement tasks, ensuring efficient operation and security. World's first 100,000-ton smart aquaculture vessel. On September 1, 2022, the Goshen No. 1, the world's first 100,000-ton smart aquaculture vessel, commenced its first fish harvest in the Yellow Sea. This initial harvest includes about 65 tons of large yellow croaker, farmed 100 nautical miles offshore under deep-sea conditions. The vessel uses advanced technology to harvest fish, transporting them from the tank to a dormant pool via a pump and conveyor system for rapid cooling and preservation. The process is fully automated and traceable. Since its launch, Guoshen No. 1 has housed over 3 million fish larvae and traveled over 3,000 nautical miles. It features 2,108 monitoring points for real-time control of water, oxygen, light, and feed, allowing for high-density farming and a reduced cycle time. Operating with a mobile aquaculture model, the vessel adjusts to seasonal conditions to ensure year-round production of high-value fish. With a total capacity of 130,000 tons and nearly 90,000 cubic meters of water, it is capable of producing 3,700 tons of premium fish annually. Harvesting salmon from submersible pens. Located 130 nautical miles off the coast of the Yellow Sea, China has launched its first submersible deep-sea fish farm, Deep Blue No. 1. Weighing over 1,500 tons and featuring an octagonal cage equivalent to the size of 2 football fields, this facility marks a significant advancement in deep-sea aquaculture. The cage's depth is adjusted seasonally to maintain optimal water temperatures for the salmon. In contrast to traditional fishing methods, this innovative vessel employs a specialized pump to harvest fish. The process involves inserting a thick tube into the net cage, which then inhales the Atlantic salmon from the sea into the vessel. The salmon are processed on board and packed into insulated boxes to preserve freshness, with the entire procedure taking approximately 45 minutes. Currently, the facility houses around 100,000 Atlantic salmon, with 15,000 fish already harvested. Unlike conventional salmon farming, which typically occurs in near-shore waters, China's approach involves breeding the fish 30 meters below the surface of the Yellow Sea. This strategy utilizes cooler water temperatures and higher dissolved oxygen levels to create ideal conditions for the salmon. The facility also incorporates measures to prevent shark attacks, further enhancing its innovative approach to aquaculture. What are the key findings and trends in production and consumption outlined in the 2024 State of World Fisheries and Aquaculture Report?
SOFIA report shows that for the first time, aquaculture has overtaken capture fisheries in being the main source of aquatic products.
Barrange highlighted that we produce 185 million tons of aquatic foods, with 51% from aquaculture. This shift boosts efforts to combat hunger and poverty, as capture fisheries remain steady. By 2032, production will grow by 10%, raising consumption to 21.3 kilos per person. By 2050, however, we need a 25% increase globally and a 75% increase in Africa to feed 9.7 billion people. the hidden issues with farmed fish. Farmed fish face challenges such as pollution, disease, and reliance on wild fish for feed. Addressing these issues involves adopting sustainable practices like recirculating aquaculture systems, which recycle water and reduce waste. Using plant-based or alternative protein sources for fish feed can lessen the strain on wild fish stocks. Improving fish health management with vaccines and better farming conditions can reduce disease and antibiotic use. Additionally, enhanced monitoring and environmental controls can help mitigate pollution and promote the long-term sustainability of fish farming.